NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 32 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. So in our last Codecast, we got the basic structure of our benchmark script working. We raised an error on purpose to make it fail, just to make sure that it would when we get to that point. But right now, it's not actually using any criteria to pass or fail. It's just running the benchmarks as the script when we do bin NerdDice benchmark. And it's just reporting those values out to us, which is fine and all, but we want to actually have something work off of those. So the other thing that we want to do here is we want to allow for the fact that, so when we're choosing criteria for our benchmark, you know, note here that we're setting a baseline, and then we'll wind up setting essentially multipliers or factors of one of these three things to use for our benchmark options here. And the reason why you do that is because this is going to be different on every computer that you run it on. So I don't know what kind of hardware my GitHub action is running. I don't know what anybody else who's working on this, what their hardware is going to be. So rather than try to set an arbitrary value in terms of the seconds that we have here for real, or that you'd want to have it essentially be a function of one of these things, and then you would make your decisions off of that. So let's go into the console and play around with this. Require benchmark. And then we'll run our first block here. Define n. Now we should be able to run that block. And you can take this and assign it to a variable. So if we want to now we have this baselines array. We can look at the first value there. And get the real value there. And we can do similar things for the other items. And then you can also, so if we want to do it like this, baselines equals, we should have that baselines variable assign the result of that block to it. So we'll just intentionally make it nil. Set it. So now we have these baselines. And then we want our random new. Let's see if we even really need that. I don't think that is going to matter for us. So the real main items we have there are random rand and our secure random. So we'll get rid of random new rand here. And then should work like that. Keep these ready for us. And then these next two parts. So now we've got our results for our first item there, and our 3d6 version of this. So got those, and now I want to do something similar here, where we get our results. So we've got, we'll call it here. Exit out. See if RuboCop is angry at us. 11 offenses. Useless assignment. They're all related to useless assignment, which we will mitigate shortly. So now we're going to create a method here. And our arguments are going to be the value and ratio if test value is greater than base time value times ratio. This is where I think we have NerdDice error. We'll throw that. Offenses. Exception class and message. Thirteen. So I guess we want to essentially fail fast on this. So after each of these, we will call baseline value. The secure random baseline for this. Our test value is that. They want to keep the label around. Take a look at this. Actually, get rid of real here. Actually get rid of the last argument here. Make that test written value dot real. So 57 So our ratios here, probably want to put those in a hash. are labels? Our hash keys here. You get the idea. I'll pause it. And so now we'll go through, make these rest of the items the keys to our hash. We'll fill in the numbers later, but again, I'll finish this. So we've got our keys. Try this out in our console. And I want to see if I can this from a string key. So that's nil. I don't think we haven't included active support hash with indifferent access here. I wonder if I can just have the report on symbols instead of this one item and see if it works. Seems to have worked. So it's gonna convert that to a string no matter what. It seems like we need to ratio we don't even need because we've got the hash. Ratio will be let that work and see. No. So we can see our ratio from the hash did print here. And I think we'll stop here and we'll pick up in the next video where we'll go in and flesh out what those ratios should be, introduce some performance issues to make sure that the script fails, and finish the script. Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.